Hello.
Everybody hates you. Everybody wishes that you were dead. Cause Peter, you suck. Peter, you suck. Peter, your music is fucking terrible. Peter, you suck. Peter, you suck. Peter, you don't do anything of value. Peter, you suck. Write some music, but instead you sit and write these bullshit songs. It's so self-loathing. Go see a psychiatrist. I hate the psychiatrist. Well, go see one anyway. I don't like the psychiatrist. You need to go see one. See a psychiatrist. I'm not going.
Are we good yet? What's that? Hello and welcome to DarthNews, special edition Poetic Justice. And today I decided not to get political. I know, I was going to get political. Don't worry, not touching that, not yet. I'm just warming you up. But today I wanted to find a story, a new story that we could all, you know, agree on. Universally. So, I did my research, you know, I did my Googling, and I found a story with a video that just warms my heart. Just makes me so fucking happy. It's truly a satisfying video to watch. I went to the depths of Google. I spent like 5 minutes, 2 minutes. Anyway, so I found an article with a video attached to it, and not only is this story unifying, heartwarming, inspiring, and just fucking satisfying, you know what I'm saying? It's just a satisfying video. Probably one of the most satisfying videos I've seen in a long time. At least a year and a half, 2 years. I don't know. I see a lot of videos. It's hard to pick. But this is up there. Okay, this is up there with the most satisfying. And why is it satisfying? Well, let me just lay down the groundwork for you. So there is a weirdo with a friend, weirdo, creepo, rapist. Just putting it bluntly, this is a rapist, and a psychopath, and an abuser, and specifically a woman abuser. These two rapists, they're following this woman down the street, and this guy is harassing her, like physically harassing her, and she's like, "Get the fuck off me!" You know, this is all security cameras, CCTV, so we can't really hear what they're saying, but we do see what happens next. Karma, fucking. This is literally universal karma. This is the universe being like, not today, bitch. So, as he's abusing this woman in the street, right, broad daylight, throwing her to the ground, a truck full of, I think, football players, soccer players, happens to just pass by at that very moment. And they're all like, what the fuck, looking out the window? And then the dude's talking shit to the bus, and then, boom. All these motherfuckers come out of the bus and just beat the shit out of this dude. It is satisfying, and this is how the world should operate. This is how people should react to I don't know, women being abused in the streets in broad daylight. You know, in New York City, multiple women have been raped in the subway in the morning. And you know what people did? They just fucking pulled out their phones and they filmed. It's a real reflection on society. But these motherfuckers in Brazil, oh, they ain't fucking around. These two fucking rapists, at least one of them, fucked around and found out. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and watch probably one of the most satisfying videos you're gonna see all year. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get to it. Applejack, hit it!
Thank you.
wasn't that just satisfying as fuck? Right? Wasn't that just like fucking... If you're a man, a real man, and you see some shit like this going down in the streets in front of you, what are you gonna do? You better do what these dudes did. Otherwise, you're a fucking coward, a pussy, and just a beta male cuck who deserves to die. Or at least get put in prison and raped. Men, women, non-binaries, time to stand up and speak up and intervene when you see shit like this. Don't be a bystander. Don't let this kind of behavior and assault take place. Stop it in its tracks. Otherwise, that train will continue to choo-choo all the way through your city. Oh yeah, this dude was driving the rape train. He was driving a rape train of abuse and destruction straight through the heart of Brazil. And unless people stood up to this rape train, it wouldn't have stopped. It would have just kept on going. Kept on raping and abusing women. And hopefully this taught them a lesson. Probably not, but I hope it did. Because I also heard the story continues, right? So the story, allegedly, from one of the people on the bus goes like this. They chase these guys 3 or 4 blocks down the street to this, like, run-down home that's kind of, like, boarded up. They get inside, and there's a bunch of dudes there that are armed. So they peace the fuck out. The guys from the bus peace out, the soccer players. Then the cops come, and then they basically surround the place and then take them to jail. So, yeah. And the one dude actually posted a video on TikTok or Instagram. I don't fucking know. But posted a video after he got his ass beat. Yeah, the rapist. The abusing rapist posted a video on social media after he got his ass beat. Apparently the video has been removed, but this is a screenshot from it. So, right there. Yeah. Apparently that's his good side. Anyway, I hope this, I don't know. I just hope it was. You decide. You know, it's like pick your own ending. Fill in the blank. I don't do drugs because I think it's cool. I do drugs because I'm addicted to them. No, I'm just joking. Don't do drugs. Addiction is a disease and it should be treated immediately. If you know anyone who's doing opioids, you know, or like benzos or trank, get them the fuck off that right now. There's a hotline you can call somewhere if you just Google it. You know, just take a benzo and Google it and then go get some help. Check yourself into rehab. Look, I don't know where this is going, but thank you so much for watching. And yeah, until next time, don't forget to pull out. It's P-O-O-L. And as always, make sure you like, share, subscribe, and hit that bell. So until we meet again, I guess stay Darth. Yep, I think I've overstayed my welcome, so see you later. What's that? You want a compilation? A compilation of what? I'm not doing any more Amber Heard compilations, so no. Huh? Oh, just like one of my old school ones? Like so non-Amber related. But I was just about to end the video. Like, literally, I just did my outro. Oh, okay, fine, alright, fuck it. Okay, I'll make it like a short compilation. God, the things I do for you, Tina. So you want a compilation? Okay. And you want a compilation? And I know you do. Yeah, I'm talking to you. You. Yeah, okay, alright. Well, what are we waiting for? Applejack! Hit it!
Are we ready to party tonight? So am I. We're gonna see some skin tonight. Yeah. Scars and all. This actually is a real scar, too. And I got a good story behind that. That was the first time that I really thought, hey, I might actually, I might die and, hey, no one's gonna remember. All right!
It's finally Friday, and whether you had a good week this week or a long, stressful one, you deserve to go out and get as drunk as possible and do something you might regret in the morning. You deserve it.
see that you're wearing another one of those kitty cat sweatshirts that you seem so fond of. Yeah, and you've glued some jewels and some flowers and things to it.
Uh-huh.
Interesting.
I like to be comfy and current.
Yeah, yeah. I did not remember that about you.
Can you fly this plane and land it?
Surely you can't be serious.
I am serious. And don't call me Shirley.
Doctor, I've checked everyone. Mr. Stryker's the only one.
What flying experience have you had?
I flew single-engine fighters in the Air Force, but this plane has four engines. It's an entirely different kind of flying, altogether.
It's an entirely different kind of flying.
That's my guilty pleasure. Oh, that's easy. The Trailer Park Boys.
Nice.
That's for sure, yeah. I really like them. Oh my God, they're like the most vulgar human beings ever invented. They're extraordinarily funny.
Right back at you.
Two back at you.
Three back at you, counting my wiener.
Always got to bring up your wiener, don't you? Huh?
Yeah, because you always ask me about it.
Yeah, fuck off.
Ask me how it is.
Fuck.
If your least favorite word is moist, and you tell people that, I hate you. And I'm every person that says that they hate the word moist, they think they're the first person who have said, they think they're that's a novel idea. Everyone hates moist. It's unoriginal and it's stupid. And stop saying that like it's interesting. My least favorite word, by the way, is injustice.
You think you have it bad right now? Well, here's a little perspective. Caitlin from Instagram is super tired from leg day.
Yo, it's crazy how the sun really work. Like, I don't even want to die no more. This is crazy.
And I don't want the world to see me. Yeah, because I don't think that they'd understand. Because everything's made to be broken. I just want you to know who I am. Yeah, dang it.
Oh.
Ready?
Woo! These nuts!
People think like the world's getting worse. No, it's not. It's the same world. Now we just know when everything bad happens because of Twitter, right? If Twitter was around during the Roman Empire, you would get the same tweets as you get right now.
I keep my visions to myself.
I'm a hustler, baby! People stare everyone who wants what?
If he literally came up to me and said, bark, I'll get on my knees and fucking bark like a dog.
I'll take you to the candy shop.
I'll let you lick my lollipop.
Go ahead, girl. Don't you stop. Whoa.
We're going until we hit the spots.
Whoa. Whoa.
Wow.
See where we've been. Can't you hold my hand and stay a while?
Till I'll never win. Your stupid thoughts are entering my brain. Silence! Why are you looking at me?
Teleport!
My Buddha guy skill will overmatch your inability to comprehend.
Bro, what are you doing?
Try that one on for size. Bukaki, bukaki, bukaki.
We're not trying to wake up the masses. The masses are sheep. We are trying to get the 5% of the male population who is capable of actually cultivating this sort of fortitude and discipline to wake up, to shed the conditioning, and to actually join us on the side of beautiful, wonderful right-wing extremism.
This meal, it's insanely good. And this is what I do. I'm a cook, and this is like the greatest meal I've ever had in my life.
You slay me. I ain't never really talked to a nomad before.
Huh. Really?
Why are you single?
Everyone's trash. All men are trash.
All of us.
All of them. They honestly are. Exactly.
As a writer, Star Wars TV shows make me feel a little bit better.
I'm like,
elaborate.
I don't have to be perfect. I mean, I think
that's just like, it's the writer thing where it's like something, I don't know. It's just like, you look at something like even Morbius, you're just like, it's
Morbin time. It's Morbin time, baby.
If that can get made, if these inconsistencies can happen, then hey, Poe Buddy's nerfed. We're all human. We all make mistakes. And like Star Wars is like, yeah, you can have inconsistencies and it's fine. You'll have the nitpickers and people, I mean, but I think it's totally right of us to call it out because it's been like, or else, or I guess that's, I think that's where we're at right now. Do we keep calling it out or do we just have to accept that, like what you said, Star Wars is just, if anything, it's going to be constant.
Is it fascism or is it democracy? Now, these are two very different forms of governing, so this should be easy to answer. Let's take free speech, for example. Is it fascism or democracy? Well, is it a conservative talking? Yes. Then it's clearly fascism, and we must destroy freedom of speech in order to save our democracy. Okay, another scenario. Got free speech, conservative talking. No, it is not. Well, is it someone using threats, intimidation, and violence to silence the opposition? Yes. Is it Hitler doing it? Yes. Then it's clearly fascism back here. Is it Hitler doing the threats, intimidation, and violence? No. Is it you doing it? Yes. Well, then it is a necessary aspect of a democracy being used to save our democracy. Thank God for you being a leftist.
Now, let's stop and look at what the average person does. They go out and they work Monday morning, Monday afternoon, Tuesday morning, Tuesday afternoon, Wednesday morning, Wednesday afternoon, Thursday morning, Thursday afternoon, Friday morning, Friday afternoon, and they earn, let's say, $35,000 a year, and they give it all to someone else. Every cent of it.
I'll kill you all. I'll drive you crazy, and I'll kill you.
Can I just say, my body, my choice.
Thank you.
It's a choice between me and my doctor.
The government should have no say in whether or not I get an abortion.
Did you just say abortion?
Oh.
Why is one pigeon worth $2 and one worth $2 million?
Why? You tell me. I don't know.
You know why? Because who his mother was or who his father was. Isn't that incredible?
Please tell me you didn't ever pay $2 million for a pigeon.
Hi, folks. I'm having some hot dogs for dinner tonight. If you wanted to know, that's what I'm having for dinner. I'm having hot dogs on a piece of bread. Okay?
Damn, bitch. Why you being so sweet, huh? You real sweet. You're like a cream pie. That's how sweet you are.
My precious little cream pie.
You like that? Hell yeah.
I don't show it all the time, but deep down inside, like, I slap shit out of all y'all.
Maybe you don't have enough clothes on.
Well, I hope I'm going to get naked in just a minute, so you better watch out.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Yeah. So I hope you all enjoyed those videos. I thought they were funny. Maybe not. Maybe it won't age very well, but then again, who does? Black people? Yeah, black don't crack. No, Asians, no. No, because as soon as an Asian hits menopause, it's fucking just... This channel is obviously demonetized, so if you want to consider supporting me in any way, shape, or form, feel free to go to my CashApp, Patreon, merch store, or just like this video. That helps out a lot. Just like it. And if you like whatever this is kind of content, then, you know, maybe subscribe. And with that said...
Hey, you know, you can just do stuff. Like, you don't need anybody's permission or anything. You just kind of come up with weird stuff you want to go do. You can just go do it. Okay. Go be weird. Okay, bye.
In a minute, I'ma need a sentimental man or woman to pump me up. Feeling fussy, walking in my Balenciennes, trying to bring out the fabulous. Cause I give way too much. I'ma need like 2 shots.
We look at the lawyer's building. I know the vacuum cleaner man. He's seen my tits.
Am I wrong?
that you bugging for, yeah.
You need some, like, water or something, or are you good for the next verse? All right, you ready?
Wishing to be the freak shit in your jeans.
Okay, and what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing Like a Virgin from Madonna.
Okay, cool.
I made it through the wilderness. Yeah, you made me feel shiny and new. How to chase my blues away.
Last year, I described someone as being the worst singer in America. I think you're possibly the worst singer in the world, based on that performance. And I'm absolutely serious. I've never, ever heard anything like that in my life.
That was horrific, man.
He told me I'm the worst singer in the world, so he can go kiss my ass.
I thought you'd never ask. There was a white substance on your shoe that I mistook for plaster. Yesterday I saw the same white substance outside the hut where the bat was kept, and suddenly it hit me. The great white bat has great white guano. That's what you slipped in. That's what was on your shoe. And that explains the abrasion on your palm. Let me run that back for you. That's what you slipped in. That's what was on your shoe. And that explains the abrasion on your palm. Damn, I'm good. Can you feel that? Huh? Can you feel it, Captain Compost? A day of redemption in at hand. Repent, and thou shalt be saved. Now let me holla at your partner, spit this game, bend your ear for a minute. Quit complaining about how you can't spin it, cause you ain't got it. You got what it takes, but not enough to get started. I hope you get the message.